Hey, it's xoshailaa. Welcome back to my channel, guys. And if you're new, welcome to my channel. So today, I finally have the awaited review of Victoria's Secret's new iconic scents. These technically aren't new, but they're new to the website. Like, it's been some years, y'all, some years, and they brought back the OGs. These are very much OG scents. But yeah, they call it the iconic limited edition line. So if you guys wanna go ahead and get these, they are still on the website. They have four scents. They have Mango Temptation, Strawberries and Champagne, a really loved one. They have a newer one they added, which is Melon Sorbet. And the infamous Pear Glace, or I used to call it Glace, but I guess it's Glace because it has a little, what's it called, apostrophe over it or asterisk. But yeah, so basically, I don't have Pear Glace to show you guys. I know everybody and their mama wanted that one. You guys, I don't really like pear greenery melon scents, and that's what it smells like to me. A more sweeter, better version of cucumber melon, in my opinion. Do not get at me in the comments. But you guys, I don't really like that one, so I don't have the one to show you guys. But I do have all of these. And by the way, I really do have some old, very years old Victoria's Secret videos. I probably will link it down in the comments below or post it on my community tab for you guys to see. Or you can look for yourself on my channel. But yes, I used to do fragrance reviews as well years ago. And I had the little like quarterback looking bottles. They literally look like a quarterback. The Body Fantasies from Victoria's Secret. I reviewed all of those and I had these old scents in there. Brings back so much memories. But yeah, guys, so they brought these back by popular demand. I guess everybody kept asking them for these scents back, even though you guys are missing a few. Like, to be honest, I want them to bring back Vanilla Lace, Secret Charm, Passion Struck, my favorite Midnight Ivy. Oh my goodness, please bring it back. That's my favorite scent of all time and on Victoria's Secret, just ever. I got so many compliments on Midnight Ivy. Please, Victoria's Secret, if you're watching this, if a rep or a manager or whatever, whoever owns it, please, please bring back Midnight Ivy and Vanilla Lace. I ain't playing with y'all, please. But yeah, guys, so they're missing a few scents, but here we just have these to show you, so let's get right into it. So the first one I have to show you is Melon Sorbet. Like I said before, this one is a newer one that they brought out recently in their summer 2020 line. I think it's called their Juice line, I'm not sure. But yeah, I was late to the game on these. I didn't purchase any summer scents until they started having sales like in the fall, and that's when I got my hands on this, and boy oh boy, was I sleeping on it. It is so, so good. And you guys, it's so funny because if you watch my other Victoria's Secret hauls, I did haul this and the lotion in a prior haul. And I was so sad because this literally ran out completely and never came back on the website. Or if it did, it sold out pretty fast. But they brought this back, you guys, as an iconic scent. So I guess everyone loves it just as much as I do. But this is Melon Sorbet. This says it has sugared watermelon, strawberry leaves, irresistibly cool. And I got two of them because I want to start stocking up before it disappears again. Can't have that. I want like 10 of them. Not even kidding. A lot of people don't like the packaging, but I think the simple packaging is kind of pretty. I don't mind it. I care about what's in the juice and the inside. So yeah. Smells so good. The only downside to this is that it's super, super light. I wish it wasn't so light. Melon sorbet smells amazing. It definitely smells like a sweet melon strawberry sorbet. It is so sweet and so fruity and so like fresh and clean almost. It's really hard to explain, but this smells very, very juicy, very fruity, very sugary watermelon, sugary strawberry, juicy, fruity, clean smell. That's what Melon Sorbet smells like to me. Absolutely, hands down, one of their best scents I have ever seen, smelled, came across. Definitely in my top five. It is absolutely amazing. And again, I got two. I do have another one in the lotion that I hauled before, but had to stock up. Like, what? Like, these are limited edition. Like, no, you won't catch me slipping, boo. The next one is a lot of people's favorites. This one is strawberries and champagne. This one says it has wild strawberry, sparkling champagne, forever bubbly. You guys, this one, let's get into it right now. You do smell a bubbly note. I don't know how they get that in there, but you do smell like a fizziness, a bubbliness. However, I don't smell strawberries. This might be just me and I might be alone on this, but strawberries and champagne smells very bitter, floral, bubbly champagne smell to me. It literally, you guys, I don't know what's going on, but it smells like rose water and ivy to me. Like, I don't know what's going on. It smells very bitter and bubbly to me, and I don't smell strawberries. Also, you would think this would be like for like a younger crowd, like very like young, fun scented, but this is actually kind of mature to me, and it really does smell floral to me. Like, I smell roses, powdery, like mature scent that's a bubbly, bitter champagne smell. That's what I smell. I don't know if my nose is off, even though I've smelled this before and I did have this before. It literally smells like a bitter leaf rose scent, like rose water and ivy to me. Please let me know if you agree that it smells a little weird or that it smells like rose water and ivy to you guys too. Please don't let me be alone on this. I don't know what's going on, but it smells like rose water and ivy. You guys, they smell the same. Like, I'm not even kidding. I don't know. And do y'all know what's crazy? This is the strongest one out of Melon Sorbet and Mango Temptation. Strawberries and champagne is actually the strongest one, but yet it smells the weirdest. Like, I don't know, but that's just my opinion on strawberries and champagne. You may not agree, or you may think differently, or you may love it. I, however, don't love it. It smells very floral again, and like, it's just not what I pictured this to be. So I remember the other strawberries and champagne wasn't my favorite either in the beginning, but I feel like it does smell the same, but I don't know. Something's just like different. I don't know. And the last scent that I got out of that line, I got 3 out of 4. This one is Mango Temptation. And this, you guys, had the same exact packaging as that summer line. I wish they would have brought out the Body Fantasies like linebacker bottle, because I love that bottle so much. I don't know why they chose to put the iconic scents in this packaging, but I mean, I don't mind at all. It is what it is. So Mango Temptation says it has mango nectar and hibiscus flower paradise found. So this is a fruity floral. Now, I'm not too fond of mangoes. That's not my favorite fruit, especially in a fragrance. But mixed with the hibiscus, I can do it. So Mango Temptation, with this one, it's also very light. Like I said, along with the Melon Sorbet, this one is super light. But it smells really good though. This one literally smells like mango nectar and hibiscus flower. Hibiscus, you guys know I don't do florals. However, I will always make an exception for hibiscus, because that is one of the most cleanest flower smells I have ever smelled. Hibiscus makes everything smell fresh, like laundry to me. Let me know if that's not just me in the comments down below. Let me know if you agree, because I feel like hibiscus makes everything very fresh and almost cotton dryer sheet-like. So this is really just a very clean, fruity floral fragrance that's a little bit light, but it smells really good to me. And it's crazy because this is not as strong as it was before. The other one literally had me gagging, and I don't get offended by scent a lot, or if ever, but the old Mango Temptation had me literally throwing up one time. Maybe TMI, but it was so strong that it literally bothered me that bad to make me sick. This one doesn't do that, and I'm pretty sure they added notes in here like the nectar and the hibiscus. I could be wrong. I don't remember the other one having hibiscus in it, but this one is a very fruity floral fresh fragrance. So if you like that fruity floral freshness of a mist and you don't want it too strong and you like mangoes, I think this one would be great for you. I do smell the mango more than the hibiscus in here, but that's okay. Like, it smells nice. So real quick, my favorite, my absolute favorite, probably on Victoria's Secret's website and out of this collection would be Melon Sorbet. I absolutely love this scent. It is such a sweet, fruity fragrance. I absolutely love it. I hate that it's so light, but I do love the smell of it. And my absolute least favorite is this Strawberries and Champagne. I am so still shocked about this because this does not smell like what I thought, but yet it smells similar, but it's not what I thought it was gonna be. This smells like rose water and ivy. I just really kid you not. Like, this smells like rose water and ivy to me. Y'all, they are the same, y'all. I'm so sorry. And Mango Temptation is just all right. I probably would not repurchase any of these again, minus Melon Sorbet. I do want to stock up on Melon Sorbet, but this one's just okay. And yeah, that's my take on that. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Hopefully I don't get too much hate because I don't like strawberries and champagne or pear glace. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy my video, and thank you to all those who were patiently waiting. I had a lot going on, but I'm back and I cannot wait to do all these videos for you guys and all y'all's requests. Now let's get right into my quote. If anyone can do something in life, why can't you? If Beyonce could do it, or your friend or someone you knew of can do something in life and go for their dreams, why can't you? What's stopping you from going for what you want in life? You can do whatever you put your mind to in life, okay? Everybody had to start off from somewhere. We all did not start off from the top, including me, even with my YouTube, for example. Like, I want to be a bigger YouTuber, but I'm still, you know, lower. Why, you know, in my opinion, am I going to watch someone else on camera but not be on camera myself when I know that's what I want to do? And I want to help people and I want to make money, be real, you know what I'm saying? Like, why can they do it but I can't, you know? Like, that's what I mean when I say that, like, why can someone else do something but you can't? That's exactly what I mean. Why should you just watch someone else do something that you want to do, or you just relate it to your situation? Why can they do it but you can't, you know? That is what I mean when I say, why can they do something and you can't? All that to say, the answer is you can. All you literally have to do is put effort in it and have faith in God. If you believe in Jesus Christ, I do. I thank the Lord for everything I have and everything he's done for me. And I just hope that he continues to bless me and my channel and my life and my kids and my family, and just everything that I touch or he touches. Just bless it all, Lord. Amen. Like, bless it all. You can do whatever you want to do in life. You just got to put faith and effort behind it, you guys. I'm serious. And pray for what you want. If it's meant for you and it's appropriate, the Lord will let it happen for you. And if something that you want doesn't happen, that doesn't mean that it may not happen for you. It just is on God's timing, if that makes sense to you. Things don't always happen how we want. Life isn't fair, but you can always try. You always have the option to try. And also, another thing I want to say to you guys, of course, at the end of all my videos, I want to encourage you. And I just want to say that, of course, we're going through a pandemic, and whatever we are going through behind closed doors, trust me, I'm going through stuff too. I get it and I feel you. But yeah, I want you to keep going. And I also want you to remember, you are important. Your life has meaning. And yes, you have value every day. I want you to remember that. Keep your head up, stay encouraged, stay positive, stay optimistic as best you can. I know we're going through hard times, and it's even hard for me sometimes. But yeah, I want you guys to stay encouraged, and that's why I say this at the end of all my videos. And I hope you guys, it resonates with somebody out there or helps somebody. So yeah. On that note, I will see you guys in my next video. I have tons of videos coming, so please make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And stay tuned, because now that the sales are slowing down, I have way more videos and requests to do. I have not forgotten. But yeah, I'm gonna do all the requested videos and all my videos that I wanna do, so stay tuned. All right, guys, I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Be blessed.